The Countifs function counts the number of items in a range using multiple criteria and multiple ranges that meet a specific criteria. All criterion must be true in order for the cell to be counted. Syntax equals countifs, criteria range 1, comma, criteria 1, comma, criteria range 2, comma, criteria 2, comma, ellipsis. Criteria range 2 and criteria 2 are optional. The criteria range 1 argument is the continuous range to be evaluated. The criteria 1 argument determines what cells to count in that range. Criteria range 2 is the second continuous range to be evaluated, and criteria 2 determines what cells to count in that range. Syntax rules for the criteria are the same as the COUNTIF. In this spreadsheet, we have a list of first names in column A and a list of last names in column B. We want to count the number of occurrences that have the word John in column A and Brown in the associated column B. We'll use the COUNTIFS function. Our first range is A1 to A6, and our criteria will be John. Our second range, B1 to B6, and that criteria will be Brown. And there are three occurrences in the range that have John in column A and the word Brown in the associated column B. In this spreadsheet, I have a list of student names in column A, the college they attend at the university in column B, and the GPA for their freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior year. I want to write a formula in cell C8 to determine the number of freshmen in the business college with the GPA greater than 3. Because I have multiple criteria, I need to use the COUNTIFS function. My first criteria range, I need to check to see if the student is in the business college. I'm going to hard code BUS because it's not clearly denoted anywhere in the spreadsheet where I can use it as a criteria. My next criteria range would be the freshman GPA. And because I'm looking for greater than 3.0, I have to follow the rules of the syntax. If we have a relational operator, we must enclose it in quotes. I have a cell reference, so I have to put an ampersand in front of it. I put the cell reference, and there is my answer. I want to copy this formula over to determine the number of sophomores in the business college with a GPA greater than 3.0. Copy it again to determine the number of juniors in the business college with a GPA greater than 3.0, and also for the seniors. So when I copy this formula, it changes the first argument to C4 to C7. Well, I'm checking for the college, so I need this range to stay the same. So I will put a dollar sign in front of both of the B's. The next range is D4 to D7. That is what I want because now I'm checking for the GPA of the sophomores. However, the last argument changes from B1 to C1. I'm checking 3.0, and 3.0 is in the cell B1, so I need to anchor it in with the dollar sign. I can then copy the formula over. In cell C9, I want to write a formula to determine the number of business students who are freshmen with a GPA equal to 3.0. I have multiple criteria, so I need to use the COUNTIFS function. My first range, I'm going to check for the college. I'm going to hard code BUS. I'm checking for the freshman GPA. There's my range. I'm checking for 3.0, which is in cell B1. And because I'm just testing for equality, all I have to do is type in the cell reference. I don't want this criteria range to change because I will always be testing for the college. B1 is always the criteria 3.0, which we're testing. So I have that anchored in. And then I can copy this formula.